BLS, basic life support. BLS is the foundation for saving lives after cardiac arrest. Fundamental aspects of BLS is immediate recognition of sudden cardiac arrest patients, activation of emergency response system, early CPR, and automated external defibrillator. In this, the most important step is like cardiopulmonary resuscitation. That means revival and return to function of the heart and lungs. Cardiopulmonary resuscitation is an emergency life-saving procedure. Consisting of delivering effective chest compressions and effective ventilation to a victim of cardiac arrest. The causes of the cardiac arrest are mostly like cardiac and extracardiac. Cardiac is ischemic heart disease, arrhythmias, shock, valvular diseases, cardiac tamponade and pulmonary artery embolism. And extracardiac is airway obstruction, acute respiratory failure, shock, electrolyte imbalance, trauma, drug overdose, drowning and poisoning. The objectives of cardiopulmonary resuscitation is return to a prior quality of life and functional state of health in a victimized patient, and to provide effective oxygenation to vital organs, and to stop degenerative processes of ischemia and anoxia, and timely intervention of BLS, that is within 4 minutes of the arrest, and ACLS within 8 minutes of the arrest. Now we are going to perform the steps of CPR. Now Dr. Sanjana will do the procedure. Now we are going to perform the components of CPR. First step is that scene safety. You have to make sure that environment is safe for the rescuer and also for the victim. And then on recognition of the cardiac arrest patient. First we have to check for the responsiveness of the patient by tapping on the shoulders. And we have to check for his breathing by chest raise. And we have to check for the carotid pulse for 10 seconds. If the pulse is not there, then we have to start call for help for another person.
I want help. You lost
him. What happened?
This patient has arrested.
Now we are going to start the chest compressions. Chest compression should be like at the level of the nipple, this one at the sternal bone. Near the sternal bone, and we have to interconnect the both the hands, and we have to give depth of chest compression 5 to 6 centimeter deep at the rate of 100 to 120 beats per minute, and for every 30 chest compressions there should be 2 rescue breaths.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30.
Now we are checking for the pulse again.
Each rescue breath should be delivered over 1 second, and there should be visible chest rise, and the advanced airway breath should be like 1 breath per 6 to 8 seconds, and the recommendation is like tidal volume is 500 to 600 ml, and there should be chest compression should be continued after the breaths up to like 100 to 120 minutes beats per minute, and after the scenario we should check pulse for each chest compression and rescue breaths. If the patient after delivering the adequate chest compressions and rescue breaths, then we have to check again for the pulse of the patient. If there is, then we have to check for the pulse of the patient.
I'm checking the pulse. There is no pulse.
Then we have to continue CPR again for up to 5 cycles.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30.
After adequate CPR and chest compression, if patient is revived by having the pulse and breathing, adequate breathing, then the patient should be shifted by securing the airway to the nearby hospital.